So let's tackle first, Doctor, pneumonia. Pneumonia, as we say in Spanish. How can you tell the difference between a cold and pneumonia?
So that's not necessarily the easiest thing, but certainly going to see a physician for a complete exam is the first way to get yourself evaluated if you're not sure what's going on. A physician will listen to your lungs and, if needed, order a chest x-ray, which can actually confirm the presence of a pneumonia.
And who's at risk for pneumonia?
So pneumonia is an infection that anybody could get.
Okay.
Certainly there are some people who are at higher risk, and those would be patients that are over the age of 65, anyone at any age with chronic illnesses such as diabetes, heart disease, lung disease, asthma, anyone who has a weakened immune system because of medications or medical conditions are all at more risk of developing pneumonia.
And is a vaccination the best way to prevent pneumonia?
A vaccination is a great way to prevent the pneumonia. The pneumonia vaccines are available. There are two that we give, and we'll be talking about that in a little bit. But that's one important aspect. It's also very important that you take care to keep yourself as healthy as possible. Make sure that you have good hand washing during cold or flu season, being careful not to be around other people who are too sick in close contact, being careful to avoid touching your face, your hands on your mouth or your eyes is a way that illnesses get spread. And so hygiene is important, general health is important, and also vaccinating is important.
And to wrap up pneumonia, do you need that every year, that vaccine?
Actually, you do not need that every year. That's a very good question. That vaccine is given as two doses 1 year apart, and then generally you may need a booster 5 to 10 years later, depending again on medical conditions and health status.